Yes, what we have discussed in the last video? In the last video, we have started with the lesson 4, that is heat and its effect. We have learned in the last video, we have discussed about the expansion of heat. How does an expansion takes place? Am I right? Expansion takes place in all the three cases, states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas. Yes or no? That all things we have discussed in the last video. In today's video, we are going to discuss about transfer of heat. How? What is meant by the transfer of heat? Can you just tell me? Transfer means what? Can you just tell me? See, I will give one example for it. Now see, if anything is kept on the flame, now you know, vessel, it is kept on the gas, what you might have observed, the pan is totally cool, am I right? And after giving the heat, it increases the temperature, the pan also becomes hot. It means when heat transfer from hot body to the cold body, that is called as a transfer of heat. In the transfer of heat, what is the concept of transfer? When the flow of a heat from the higher temperature to the lower temperature. For example, now see, if anyone has fall ill, now suppose if your friend or someone is having a high temperature, how you can recognize that a particular person is having the high temperature? When you touch the particular person, you can get the sensation, am I right? You can see the sensation that the body is hot, am I right? How you recognize that the body is hot? Because your hand is cool, and after when you sense the hot body, you can feel it as a hot, am I right? So when the transfer of heat takes place from the higher temperature to the lower temperature, are you getting? The flow of heat from the higher temperature to the lower temperature is called as a transfer of heat. Now there are mainly the three types of transfer of heat takes place. But before going to that, which are the three types, I would like to give one example. Now imagine suppose this is a teacher, and if the teacher wants to pass the notebook, the particular teacher wants to distribute the notebook, then how the teacher will distribute the notebook? Can you just tell me? The first way is that teacher will pass the notebook to the students, am I right? The teacher will pass the notebook to the students. One by one, the notebook will pass to the students. Am I right? The notebooks will be passed from one person to the another. This is the one way. Am I right? In the second condition, teacher will tell the students to form a line, to make a line, and will distribute the notebook one by one. Am I right? What is the second way? Teacher will tell the students to form a line and will call the number of students and will distribute the notebooks. This is the second way. The third way, what the teacher will do? Teacher will throw the notebooks directly to the students. Teacher will throw the notebooks directly to the students without moving from the place. Are you getting? These are the three ways. Am I right? The first way is that teacher will distribute the notebook from one person to another. In second way, the teacher will call the student, will ask the student to make a line and will distribute the notebooks one by one. And in third case, teacher will directly throw the notebooks to the particular students. Am I right? So like that, in the nature, the heat transfer, it takes place by the three way, that is conduction, convection and radiation. That is conduction, convection and radiation. Are you getting this? So the transfer of heat takes place by conduction, convection and radiation. Today in this video I am going to only discuss about the conduction. What is the conduction? If you I have given the first example that what is the actually the conduction. The molecules, conduction is the process of the heat in which there is no actual movement of molecules. For example, now see, I have given the example of the teacher and the student. The first example, what we will do, the teacher will distribute the notebook to one from one person to the another. Am I right? The teacher will distribute the notebook from one person to another. So like that, here the molecules will transfer from higher temperature to the lower temperature. For example, now see, if you will take a pan, if you will take a pan, okay, and if you will apply some heat, suppose this is a burner, and if you will apply some heat, and if there is one spoon here, okay, what will happen actually? If you will see the spoon, this part will get first heated, am I right? Then the heat will transfer from here and after that to the to the end of the spoon. Am I right? The directly the heat will not transfer here. Am I right? The first the heat will transfer from the inside to the outside. Am I right? So the heat here, this rays are not moving till here. The transfer of heat takes place. Am I right? The conduction is the process of heat transfer from the body without actual movement. If you will compare this conduction with the given example of the students, here the teacher is standing here and students are also on the place. The teacher is only distributing the notebooks. The teacher is only passing the notebook. Am I right? So this is the process of conduction. Are you getting this? So I hope you have understood the process of conduction. Now actually the conductor is of two type, good and bad conductor. Good and bad conductor of a heat. Now what is good and bad conductor of a heat? For example, now if you will take a glass or a vessel, in that if you will put some put spoon, steel spoon, scale, pencil, then if you will keep scissor, okay, such things if you will keep in that, knife, okay, if you will keep, and if you will heat this vessel for some times, after applying heat, when you will remove that things, you can see that steel spoon is hot. Am I right? Then scale is cool. Am I right? It is at normal temperature. Pencil is as it is made up of wood, it is also at normal temperature. Am I right? So there are some material which can allows the heat to pass. That is called as a good conductor. Or we can simply say they are the conductor of heat. While some material does not allow the heat to transfer. That is called as a bad conductor, or another name is insulator. For example, you can take pencil, wood, or you can take example of wood, plastic. They are the example of the insulator, while the good conductors are the means which allows the heat to transfer. For example, aluminium, steel, brass, these are the example of a conductor. Are you getting? These conductors are mainly classified as a good and bad conductor. Then can you give any example? Can you just tell me what are the uses of conductor? See, there are also the uses of conductor. For example, now see, if you will take we prepare the food in aluminium. Am I right? Why we prepare the food in aluminium? Because it helps, means that the food will cook at faster rate. Am I right? The food will cook at faster rate. Am I right? So we cook the food in the aluminium or in the steel. Am I right? And there are some also uses of the insulator. For example, now if you will see, there are for any pan, aluminium or any, if you will take a cooker, there is a plastic handle to it. Why there is a plastic handle? Because it does not allow, although the cooker will be hot, it will not make us harm. Am I right? So it is that is the use of insulator. Are you getting? For example, also we wear the woolen cloth in winter. Why do we wear the woolen cloth in winter? Because woolen is a bad conductor of heat. It does not allow the air to trap inside. So we wear the woolen cloth in the winter season. There are many examples. You can find it and write in your physics notebook. For example, the Eskimos. The igloos are made up of the snow. Am I right? So what is the use? That is also the example of the insulator. Are you getting this? So these are some examples. So today's work will be, whatever I have taught you, just listen again and write, make a note and write in your physics notebook. Write the good and bad conductor in your physics notebook. Thank you.